Hi all, this is R Pranky with another tutorial video for Eyewire. This is one of the practice cubes that come after the tutorial cubes. So you're not going to get immediate feedback while you're working on it, you'll get some afterwards and you're going to be getting points. Let's get started. And I'm going to start up here with the piece that is touching the edge of the cube. I like to start with that piece because then I can just work my way across the cube and I feel like I'm less likely to miss something. So let's get started now. Okay, so it's moving down to this sort of bulbous area. And I can see there's something else up here, but I'm gonna deal with that later. I'm gonna continue following this first. All right. So this is interesting. I think it may be branching in two separate directions. So it's going here to the right, you can see that. But if I click here, it looks like it may also be going down. So let's add that and then go take a look in the 3D to make sure that actually does go. So remember, you can zoom in the 3D and then right click and drag to kind of get a better look. And that actually looks like it fits in really, really well. So we're gonna have those two pieces and we're gonna follow one at a time. So let's follow this one first. And I choose that one because it's a little bit smaller and I think it's gonna hit the edge first. So let's focus on that one, and it's the one up here. Alright, so that one just disappeared clean off the edge. Let's go back and follow the other one now, this one that's going down. Let's see where it goes. Alright, we're getting close to the edge of the cube now, which means we're almost done with this branch. Alright. Interesting, it's sort of spinning around a little bit. Let's continue. Alright, so it looks like it's splitting into a couple of little different things, so let's make sure we get them all. Okay, so that looked like it disappeared. Now let's make sure this does as well. Alright, and so I'm just going to turn it over and take a look in the 3D. So see how these all have sort of rounded edges? That's what we're looking for, and that's a good indication that this does actually end here before the edge of the cube. If they had a jagged edge or a flat edge, that means that there might be something missing. All right, so now we want to double click and move back up here, because I think I noticed some missing stuff up here, and it looks like there might be a little bit more to this branch. Let's see. So here's the missing stuff I noticed earlier. Okay, and let's go follow this little branch and see if that ends or if it continues. Alright, so that looks... this is interesting. It looks like it probably continues here. Not any line, so let's color that in. And so you may have noticed that in the 3D it added this big, long branch. That's a good indication. See how it's going the opposite direction? That's a good indication that this does not actually belong. And if we zoom in a little bit, can see that it looks like this light blue one actually is just hitting this one. It doesn't look like it fits together at all. So it looks wrong, so we're going to deselect it. And I'm going to use control click in the 3D to deselect these little pieces. The reason why I'm doing this in the 3D instead of the 2D is because sometimes it's difficult to tell how what you see in the 3D that's clearly wrong quite relates to what you see in 2D, so it's a little easier in the 3D sometimes. So now I think we're done, so let's progress to the next one.